Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to discuss a very specific area in sports that many athletes often seek services for. It's called overcoming the practice performance gap. We're going to cover one way to bridge a performance gap between how athletes practice and how they compete. Transferring performance from practice to competition is at the core of athletes who want to display their skills to their full potential on the big stage. Along the way, many athletes are presented by a plethora of both external and internal distractions, such as who's watching, how much the competition means to the athlete, what's at stake, how they're physically feeling, any injuries, environmental conditions, and more. What we know from sports science studies is that athletes who lack exposure to competition struggle more with the combative effects of stress in comparison to athletes who face competition more often. So one powerful solution to bridging the practice performance gap is to schedule more competitions. Before going into this solution in more detail, let's first discuss the biggest mistake made among many athletes. For many athletes, they take part in the waiting game. Instead of entering competitions on a consistent basis, they instead wait until they feel ready enough to compete. This mistake derives from the perfectionist mindset, where the athlete's mind is in search of safety, constantly probing if they have what it takes to compete. Almost always, the wandering mind will uncover areas of uncertainty, which convinces the athlete to take more time off to train and prepare before competition. In my early work at SPMI, I came across this experience with a professional tennis player who sought out services due to this struggle. We worked on her mental game for a period of 3 months. Throughout that time, she decided to not play any tournaments and instead worked on her game in practice for 6 months. This gave her time to get in the best physical, technical, and what we believed at the time, mental shape of her life. As a result, her game improved significantly, especially on the mental side, as she even started beating her coach on a consistent basis. However, after the 6 month training period ended, she resumed competition, only to be greeted by the same heightened levels of anxiety. This preparatory mistake changed my entire approach to working with athletes. Now at SPMI, it's imperative for athletes to compete on a consistent basis while going through the program. This doesn't mean that athletes need to compete in an organized competition by any means. What it means is that we're able to simulate their practice environment in a way that mirrors the same mental and emotional demands of competition. Even during COVID-19, we get very creative by implementing the judgmental nature that competition brings into their practices so that athletes can continue to work on overcoming the brain's fear signal. One powerful way in doing so is to set up a practice competition, such as a practice match in tennis or a scrimmage in baseball. Now, the practice alone isn't enough to simulate the judgmental nature of competition and the threat it plays on the mind's ego. For that, I have my clients go live with their practice competition by broadcasting it through Instagram or Facebook. This approach may sound very uncomfortable and intrusive, and believe me, it is. And that's the point. We want to bring out those same feelings, as those are the feelings, emotions, and thoughts that you'll be facing come game time. This training intervention is not about end results. It's simply about facing the same elements of competition that induce anxiety and fear. The same elements that hold so many athletes back from performing to their full potential when it counts. So as you move forward to improving your mental game, I encourage you to also commit to this activity and take pride in the number of times you face the fear while remaining non-judgmental when it comes to your performance results. The results will get better through deliberate practice and consistent exposure. Also, this intervention works well even under incomplete settings, such as in practice when it's not possible to get together with the entire team. The goal is to challenge the brain's ego, the part of the mind that is inciting fear, negative thoughts, and strong emotional and physical feelings. The ego can be challenged whether an athlete is training with the team or individually. It just comes down to understanding what emotional fear the athlete doesn't want to face and exposing the athlete to it in practice. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you enjoyed it, please like the video as it greatly helps out the channel. Also, if you're interested in continuing to improve your mental game, then I encourage you to subscribe to the new SPMI TV channel. I'll continue to post the latest mental toughness videos, podcasts, webinars, and more to help serve every athlete, parent, and coach. In addition, if you're interested in taking your game to the next level, please check out the company website below. At SPMI, I offer mental toughness courses, group training, and live one-on-one mental training from the comfort of your own home. So get out there and work on becoming the best version of yourself. And until next time.